Hello, friends. This is Martin from Secrets, the channel for learning about trading and investing. Welcome to Markets Tomorrow, the daily market analysis, where we look at what happened in the market during the day and how we can look forward for a better trading plan for the next day. So this is analysis for March 15, Tuesday, 2022. And what kind of day we had this bulls are charging up and the markets went up. And it was the fifth day of upmoving, like 7.5% of the recovery that happened in the Nifty. Bank Nifty also recovered near 10%. So Nifty is actually caught in mid of a gap. No, so whether we'll be able to overturn this or not in the next day is what we need to keep a close watch on. So let's go ahead and see what pre-market analysis that we can do. We'll be doing it based on all these parameters that is on the left side. In addition, analysis will be on the parameters that you see. We'll have some actionals and wrap up also. And this is for March 15, as I said before, Tuesday, tomorrow. And I'll be going a little quicker because the video length has been keeping on extending for up to half an hour and more sometimes. So I need to cut short to half. So look at the candlestick. It's a wide range bullish candle that has happened, right? It is a support zone, is from where it had continuously been moving up. So here also the wide bullish, it's almost like an open circle low pattern also. So it's clear bullishness that you can see from the candlestick back pattern. It's a 7% recovery from the bottom, 7.5 7.6. this is almost a 10% recovery from the bottom of the magnitude. So that's 241 points gained with 1.4% 1.5% of upmoving that happened in the Nifty, and wide range bullish happened. 20 DMA also was taken out, right, which is very positive. Alright, and 7.5% is the routed recovery that happened from the bottom, and still in between the gap, and 208 DMA also is above. Right, so price action, there is a trend line channel on the downside, we're in the edge of the channel breakout, and the top double top M pattern is also visible on the weekly. Bank Nifty similarly 766, that's very bullish move that has happened today, 2.2% up move as compared to the previous close, and a wide range bullish candle is what it ended up in the Bank Nifty, right. And the recovery is nearly 10% from the bottom, as I said before. So, but you can see that it is still far away from the 200 DMA, 20 DMA. It's below that, and the gap resistance also is there on the upside. We're seeing the charts in the resistance support levels. We are discussing that. We'll see the chart of what we are talking about, right? And intraday, if you look at, this is what happened, right? Trending upward from the morning, non-stop. Nifty and Bank Nifty both. Bollinger Bands are saying what? No, the volatility is naturally because the distance from the band to the upper and the level is high on both indices, but 20 DMA is conquered, which shows there is a potential up move ahead, and contraction also shows that the down move is probably arrested for some time. Okay, lower band contraction also can be seen. So that's what is mentioned here, right? According to the bands, there is an expansion, it's the reason for the volatility, but the downside expansion has stopped and it has turned to contraction, which indicates there is some pause that has happened. And the Bank Nifty also has to close above this 20 DMA before we can make a good clue out of this, right? Support resistance levels, we're in the mid of the gap on the Nifty on the left side. So the immediate resistance zone where it is currently is 16,800 and 16,900, which is also a Fibonacci 38 retracement levels, earlier retracement, which is now acting as a resistance. And on the above that is the resistance of 7,000. We should be closing the gap, and above that you have 7200 300, and above that you have 7350 to 7400, and above that 7500 to 7600, which is Fibonacci 23 retracement levels. Downside for support would be 16,750, that's all. Then you have 16,550, 16,650, then you have another gap that has formed, 16,350, 16,450 zone, which is Fibonacci 50 retracement level also. Below that 16,200, then 15,950, 900 zones, which is the Fibonacci 61 retracement level. That's on the Nifty, right hand Bank Nifty. The immediate resistance would be at 35,000 kind of levels, Fibonacci 50 retracement also, and above that you have resistance at 35,600, 900, that zone, and then above that you have 36,300, 36,800 levels, which is the Fibonacci 38 retracement. Above that you have the gap that's coming, which is 36,900, and 37,000 would be where the gap is there, and any close above 37,500, which is Fibonacci 23, would be closing the gap also, right? So that's the support resistance of the Bank Nifty. Momentum divergence, there was a divergence in the momentum which had met the target today clearly at 16,790 or something, right? So that is done with. The momentum, if you see, it's moving in the sideways on the Nifty. In Bank Nifty also, it's in the sideways on. So it's in the sideways in the medium term also on both indices, right? And main thing is the medium term, it is the momentum supported RSI 40, which is positive, right? So momentum diverges worked well, momentum is sideways, and momentum of the medium term also sideways, which is moving upside, which is clearly bullish. Trend indicators are showing that it is crossed over the bullish zones on the Nifty, but still remain in the bearish zones at the crossover, right? Both the trend is downside falling with the strength. In the medium term, we have bearishness that continues there. So short term recovery has happened at the trend of the Nifty, but magnitude yet to happen. Volatility is pulled off slightly, the flat time 1% of down more, and 35.67 is IV is 77.56, almost at the top of the implied volatility percentile. So anything above 25, we have to be cautious, right? So it's like, looks like it is holding off from the 30 levels to the 25 levels, whether it will drop off to the 20 or not, that's what we have to closely watch. So as long as the war is there, it's less unlikely to cool off that easy. And open interest analysis is showing that there is some something that needs to be. This chart that you see here is not updated, so we will go to the options open interest directly and then we'll discuss about it directly. So this is the Nifty open interest data. So you can see that the highest resistance is 17,500 and the highest support is seen at 17,500 is the wide range, no? Because you have 2-3 days more left for the expiry to the Thursday. And the second level of resistance will be seen at 17,000. After 17,500, 17,000 is where the highest resistance is seen, support is seen, the resistance is seen. And the put, if you look at 15,500 is where the second level of highest put writing is seen as of now. So you can see some unwinding of the calls have got reduced today, right? And put call range is 0.9, very close to the bullish zones, but not at there, right? Almost it's clear, it's heading towards put call range is heading towards the bullishness. The Bank Nifty, this is for the 17th March expiry. Bank Nifty, if you see, it's 36,000 is the highest call writing, and after that, you have 38,000. So, 22,000 points of range is what on the resistance side, call side, and highest put writing is in at 34,000, and after that, you have far away 32,000 points there. So, some unwinding of the call positions also can be seen. And we have 17 marches few days more ahead, while the open interest data will get the world of surprise moves, right? So, it's open interest. So, here the put call ratio is one, clear bullish. So, put call ratio is bullish, right? And the ranges are wide because of the volatility. Now, futures open interest is clearly showing a long buildup that has happened in the Nifty and the Bank Nifty both, right? So, I'm sorry that this chart was not updated, but yeah, so this is the heat map. We can see that it's all bullish, all the major heavyweights are all clearly green. All sectors performed except some of the pharma, energy, cement and all of this, but major sectors, financials, auto and IT performed well. So index heavyweights, if you see, STFC did a very good move. It was a good bounce up, and it was a bullish bullish candle that happened, and the momentum is also rising from the sideways upwards. HDFC Twin also is a green close, but there is a resistance immediately on the above. It has climbed into the sideways zone anyway. Lions is giving a green candle, bullish candle. This is all daily candles, and sideways and heading towards the bullish zones in the momentum. So, Infi is also showing very good bullishness and is already in the bullish zones in the momentum point of view. So, the sector is also doing good, the only sector that is bullish. TCS again at his work, bullish within the channel, sideways momentum. As is a bank, bullish candle showing, right? Climbed above the major support zone back. Now next cuddle would be this major support that would act as resistance now on the upside. Momentum has climbed inside this. The bounce up in the Kodak Bank can be clearly seen, and it is heading towards the next resistance in the upside from where it had slipped earlier, and it is having sideways moment also. So overall, there are some bullishness that you can see. The bounce up that can be seen in the banking sector. IT is also doing good. And Reliance is also doing good. Right. So overall, all sectors are doing fine, but when you consider it bullish, Infi is leading. Right. Rest is all recovering and Reliance. Infi and Reliance is where you can say clear bullishness. Almost getting, other sectors are all short bullish today, but overall, if you see, it's picking up in the momentum. Sector performance is almost 2% IT moved, and it's a bullish one, so you can pick up stocks in the IT. A lot of IT beaten down stocks like Wipro, Tech Mahindra, HCL, all of these have beaten down, have got enough of correction now. So, in the episodes, it's on the recovery path. So, the metal is flat, close, right? It was in the bullish zones in the short term, but it has slipped, so let's wait. Auto gained 1%, but still in the bear zones. Pharma flat 0.3, it's in the bear sideways zone. So auto is only sector that is in the bearish. This is all sideways or IT is bullish. FMCG also sideways, flat. Reality also 2% down actually, but still remain momentum on the sideways. So sideways momentum across the sectors, bullish only in the IT. Metal slipping between bullish to sideways. Auto is remaining the bullish, although across sector up more happened today. Institutional participation data is not available as of now, but as usual, this has had been selling consistently for the last several months, and that is something that it did. Today must be different slightly. If I selling might have got reduced, or day might have increased substantially thereby. Dollar USDNR, you can see that it is breaking out from 76.5 and then again heading to 76. There may be central intervention that may be happening, but today also the rupee weakened. And US dollar, we can see that it is heading up towards 99. It almost hit there earlier, so it may be taking out. It's about to take out now. So dollar is strengthening, rupee weakening. That with great momentum. And crude oil has cooled off substantially due to some fundamental news that might have kind of come out. And it is at the medium of the channel, and it is at 102. Still, it is at very high levels, and the momentum has also slipped in the sideways zone. So that's only good news that you can hear in the midst of all the chaos and the global crisis and all that. Gold is also facing resistance after hitting almost near to the all-time high. Been showing red candles in sense, but the momentum is still in the bullish zone. So it can bounce up and move once again. Probably it may come back to the support zone and then bounce from here. Never know. But it was a clear breakout that had happened. So let's wait and watch. Dow Jones, all the US markets across, you can see that it had slipped from the major support zones. This is Dow Jones. It has climbed back to the sideways zone, but it is struggling to get back to this major support zone which it had slipped from, and now it will become a resistance. Next support downside would be 32,100 kind of level, so probably it may be heading towards that and then moving up, or maybe consolidating in this level, or maybe trying to climb into this same support zone again. Here also in the Nasdaq also you can see that is slipped off from major resistance and now finding the next resistance on the downside and heading towards that mostly. Momentum is actually bearish, right? Unlike the climb that happened in the Dow Jones. S&P 500 also momentum is heading towards bearishness. Major support is broken and it seems like bearishness is there across all the major US indices, where it is losing grip. Right, so significantly, keep a close watch on this. It's all daily charts. You see, two actions: Gujarat's Narmada Valley is breaking out clearly. There may be some pullback that may happen because a steep vertical move has happened. So, wait for that dip to buy in. And this is a weekly chart, but entry has to be done on a daily candle. Sorry, great volume, great momentum, and super trend. That's the reason for the pick. Sunflower is a swing or a positional trade. It's a weekly breakout that is happening. It's trending within a very good channel. It's in the middle of the channel. If it is a short term swing, it can give up till the channel top, you know, but its positionally it may be, you know, there are a lot of resistance, so this is mostly its positional buy. Because some pullbacks can happen when it is moving upside. There could be a cup and handle formation also possible, it can slide up, all that is possible, but Pharma is not crashing as such. It is a weekly breakout. This stock is good and this is a weekly candle. Positional, but this is more of, you know, long swings or positional, you can say. But the other one is a swing. You have to make the entry only on a pullback on the Gujarat Narmada Valley. Right? The wrap-up is a neutral mild bullishness. Right? The reason of the mild bullishness is very evident from the chart pattern, support resistance levels, the sideways momentum, sideways trend, Bollinger Bands turning sideways, all so combined to that, you know, sideways view. You know, because bullish, clear bullish view cannot be taken unless it closes above the 200 DMA. So 7.5% recovery in 5 days has happened, 15% correction has happened earlier, 20 DMA major DMA support, 20 DMA is reclaimed today, top formation is still there, trend line downside is there. Fire selling also is there, so it's a mixed pack. So any green close above 17,000-37,500 could be giving us hope for a further up move. It means above 200 DMA close also may be happening by that time. So a lot of war uncertainty is still there in the market. Volatility is very high, 25% also is high. US Fed meeting is there in the next Thursday in our time, so there may be volatility. This FIS selling is continuing and non-stop selling is what is happening. The positive move of 10% recovery in the bank Nifty and 7.5% Nifty is all good, but you know, until the global uncertainty on the war crisis, Ukraine, Russia war, crisis is there, all this may get negated in a matter of a day or a single day's gap up or gap down, right? So we have to be very cautious as long as it is moving above the 20. Hedging with the gold can be done on long-term investments until market recovers, and SIPs of quality stocks can be bought at this. Levels still, you know, some of the character good quality stocks may be, you know, at very cheap levels. So optional hedges, risk defined strategies as we use for the overnight positions intraday, of course it has to be tight stop loss. So the view is neutral to mild bullishness is what I have for the next day. So I hope this helps you to frame your own market view for the next day and your own trade plan. If that helps you in any way, consider hitting the like button and share it to friends and colleagues. We have very few subscriptions, so appreciate your help in this regard to keep us motivated to keep doing that every day. Thanks so much. Happy trading, happy learning. Bye.